of time. I went to fully booked at the Ford, and they said they were sold out. So I was like, what? Baka best in Western Russia. So then I went to this other place, and they ran out also. So I'm like, question mark. And then there was this other bookstore. I'm not going to mention the name of the bookstore, but they're a Christian bookstore, and they were closed on a Sunday. Right? So we'll here. Oh, that's Lynn. Yeah. So I was like, why did I think about that? But, you know, so I'm just really happy for her to see that she's now out with her first book. How I came to know Rika, or Carla as I call her personally, is we were together in the morning show a couple of years back for almost 4 years. And this girl, like, you know that if you have to wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning and you have to be ready to go by 4:30, how many of you know that the real personality comes out in the morning? Right? Yeah. So I'll be the first to tell you that Rika is a horrible person. Yeah, she's horribly on time, horribly professional, horribly good at what she does, and she's just horribly funny. So all the years that I've worked together with her, it's one of those things where, you know, we have this special friendship, or at least I think so. So where when I see her, I light up. I'm so excited. I'm like this little puppy because she just makes me laugh all the time. So, but more than that, I know that this woman, I have seen her grow over the years. When we first started together on this morning show, we were both newbies to morning television. She was also a newbie at church. She had just started going to church at that time. And she was also just freshly enrolled in Ateneo. So that was about the time that, you know, things were all the way to take off for her. So she enrolled in Ateneo and she took up literature in English, right? So she took that. And while we were in the morning show, I would really see her working hard. So she wouldn't get much sleep. Can you imagine two jobs? And a full-time, going to school full-time in university. That's crazy, aside from all the other little sideline gigs that she was doing. So in the morning, she would take a quick nap, and then I'd see her studying and writing and writing and writing. And another little story that I want to share with you guys is that when I was putting up my own website, I was talking to the developer, the person who also did Rika's website, and I was saying, like, you know, so how do I get started, this and this and that. She's like, oh, well, you know, like, Rika has many entries already. She has at least a year's worth of entries to do her blog. And I'm like, dang it, that girl works so hard. How am I gonna match up to that? No, but she just really is passionate. You know, she's a passionate person. And when she's decided on doing something, she really goes all out and she's very good at it. If you guys haven't already read some excerpts from the book, I've already read about 4 or 5 chapters, and as always, I'm impressed. And I even last night had a chance to do one of the chapters with my son, which I thought maybe might be an interesting little exercise to do with you guys later. I can workshop for all guys. So anyway, without further ado, I'd like to call on the book editor, of course, the Step One, to come up and give us some opening remarks.